going to talk for a few minutes here about some of the problems that are involved. We read about it, we hear about it on the news. Many people are concerned, some are frightened, and people want to know where we stand here in the southeast of the United States concerning the resettlement of refugees. And without being rude or ugly or unwelcoming, we want to know what the facts are as much as we can, okay? And I want to welcome now Michael Carroll and the Reverend Larry Bateman. Now, you're both ministers.
Yes.
Okay, all right.
Retired.
And we're talking about resettlement.
Yes.
Now, where does South Carolina stand now?
Right now, our governor right now is, I think she's still in the trying to make a decision about how to go about it. The counties now are beginning to say, well, we want to talk about this too, and we want to come up with a resolution of how we stand about this. Now, here in Greenville County tonight, we will have the county committee talking about a resolution, and they are vehemently opposed to any refugee resettlement until they can be 100% fully vetted by the FBI and those involved with the security.
To be sure that they don't have ulterior motives to come in here and maybe do us harm.
Yeah, right.
Which is like in Paris, for heaven's sake,
that
just recently happened.
Right now in the United States, we have the FBI is investigating almost 1,000 of these terrorists in the country right now.
And we know we have 1,000 terrorists within our borders right
that
now.
That are being watched, they're investigating.
That's conservatively speaking.
Mm-hmm.
Well, can we not evict them from our country if we know that they're terrorists? Why do we allow them to stay? I'm just asking what I'm sure a lot of people out there ask the same question.
Yeah. Well, we don't know, and you know, we're not in government to be able to respond to that, but the president makes a determination of how many people he wants to bring in as refugees, immigrants to come into the country. Mm-hmm. That's a presidential choice. If you don't like it,
has that always been that way?
Since
that the president can decide how many people are coming? I never knew that.
The federal government has that authority.
It's a federal law. They can do that. And it's done through the State Department. Mm-hmm. And there are, in a normal process, there are 9 different agencies that have refugee settlement centers around the world. And the State Department kind of funds that and helps get people into these channels to come and be resettled here. But this whole thing that's popped up with Syria is extremely alarming.
It's
because
frightening.
One man from the United Kingdom engaged a person to get a Syrian passport, and for $2,000 he was able to get his picture on a Syrian passport and have it sent to him, and he had that to say, I'm a Syrian. And this was all fraudulent because ISIS has captured all of the presses that do the printing of this and the paper and everything. And even a person that examined it very carefully, a specialist, said that he couldn't say that there was anything wrong with it. It looked good. It looked like it was the real thing. Mm-hmm. So one of the terrorists that came into Paris came in with a Syrian passport. And we don't know how many others there are, and they're looking for them now. But right now, what the situation is there's an agency in Spartanburg, World Relief Spartanburg, that has brought in like 61 people in the upstate. And probably 80% of them are supposed to be Christians. We love people. You know, we're not against people. And we'd like to help people. But the problem is that it's not just a matter of are they a refugee, but what about Christian refugees? There's a good percentage of people in Syria that were Christians, that were there. Mm-hmm. And they've been severely persecuted, and they just can't go into a UN camp and just pile in there and hope that they'll get into one of these nine slots to be able to come here, because they'll be do that in the fear of their life.
Yes.
Because it's extremely dangerous for them. So, you know, the president said today that, you know, we don't have any litmus tests for, you know, religion. Well, we do. We've got basically mostly Muslims that are vetting Muslims to be able to come here. And that's a little fuzzy, but we're very much concerned about people slipping through the cracks and coming in here. And
it just takes one person with an evil right. motive.
Sure.
One of the things that people don't understand, it's not just a matter of what religion you are or what culture you are, but the three books of Islam, all three say it's okay for you to go and migrate, go someplace and migrate and spread your religion. It's okay for you to say, yeah, I'll assimilate with you and I'll go your way. And it's okay to lie about that and then to slowly just incrementally creep in to take over and flip the society and make it Sharia law.
And that's what happened in France. Mm-hmm. They have been assimilating into it, or going there.
I know.
And acting like they love the country, but in their hearts, they don't consider themselves French people.
Mm. And the people that were involved in that terrorist attack and there were French nationals that were involved in that.
Yes.
So, you know, there's, you know, in York County, there's 3,800 acres where there's an ISIS training camp that's there.
In York County, South Carolina.
And so these people, once they come here, could move and relocate any place in the country they want. And they get in these enclaves and all kinds of problems break out, like they have had in Dearborn, Michigan, where huge populations, you know, Polish came in there and settled it in the early 1900s. And now there's a huge rush of Muslims that are there.
Yes.
All right. Now, we have to be concerned with our part of our country, of right. our state. Mm-hmm. Where do we stand now? As of now, what does our governor and what do our people say about this?
We have had several counties that have brought up resolutions, and
the governor has to sign off when the State Department says, okay, the president wants to send refugees
yeah.
here. Okay, the governor has to sign off on that. She has today rescinded that in part to say no Syrian refugees.
All right. Okay.
That's good news. But there's 50 nations in the world that have a predominantly Muslim
yeah.
population. So it's too limited. So Greenville County tonight is going for broke on this, and they're asking to shut down everything, is my understanding.
So
what that
does is it shuts down the state's ability, the state to fund these programs.
Okay.
Because after 90 days, the federal government say, you're on your own now. And then the state has to pick it up.
And then we have to pick up the tab.
And the way they force it on you.
The only thing we need to be, you're not saying that all these people are evil or
no.
all these people are out to do something bad.
No.
But it takes one person in the group and you've got chaos.
And, here's
Paris.
Another scary thing about this, and it's simply the cost effect on our communities.
Yeah.
When
most people don't realize that. The federal government says, look, it's our program and we're funding it. And so here it is and you get it. Here's the money. Okay, that's fine. But that only goes for 90 days.
And after 90 days, we have to pick up the tab.
Then the state
and the counties
do.
We don't have much time. But right now, as we sit here, our governor has said, no way. We're not accepting.
To Syrians.
Only Syrians.
Yeah, we're not accepting Syrian
right.
refugees at this point.
Right.
And we have to be able to prove that to stay safe. That is our government's job.
Yes,
to
it is.
To keep us safe.
Right.
That's their primary number one job.
So now, should people contact their legislators? Should they call the governor's office?
Absolutely.
What do you want people to do?
They should call the governor's office and say that we do not want you to fund this. We should call our county commissioners and say we don't want you to fund this. And we should also call our senators and congressmen, because they are coming up with a bill. Senator Sessions of Alabama has come up with a bill that is going to say we're cutting the funding.
Okay, so we need to call our governor. We need to call
everybody from the lowest level,
legislators,
to the top,
and tell them, our senators, whatever, and tell them, be careful. We want to be sure before we move ahead. We have to be, our safety is our first thing for our citizens.
That's right.
You've got international pressure coming from Paris.
Yeah.
Okay. You've got peer pressure coming from governors throughout, like 26 across the country today, that are standing against this.
You say, no way. We're not having
this. No, we're not having it.
We are out of time. Will you come back as this unfolds and bring us more news?
Yes. Be happy to.
Yes.
Okay. And I'll keep that number here if you didn't get it. But we need to know what's going on around us for our own safety and our families. Wherever you are, God bless you. We'll see you next time.